might be worth something someday. Now, subsequent to this search, you had Deputy Forgy go to the Anthony home, is that correct?
Which, subsequent to which search?
The search of the vehicle, the white Pontiac Sunfire.
He went to the house, yes. I don't remember if it was upon my request or Sergeant Allen's, I don't recall.
Were you present when the dog was deployed in the backyard?
I don't believe so, no. I was actually going out of town that weekend.
Were you present during any other cadaver dog deployments other than the two that you testified to here today?
There were a couple of tips that came in where a cadaver dog was requested. I can't recall independently which tips they were. I know there were some. So, yes, I was present at some others where we didn't find any other human remains.
Okay. Do you know if you deployed, if Deputy Forgy was ever deployed at the location where Kaylee Marie's remains were found?
That specific location, no, but I do know that he was deployed at the end of Suburban Drive on probably more than one occasion, the far east end, the dead end.
What about subsequent to Kaylee's remains being found? Was he deployed there to see if there were any more bones or anything like that?
I can't recall.
If I can have just a moment, Judge.
The witness, please stand down.
Sir.
Just a second.
Yes, sir.
Just a second before you start.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Mr. Bias, you may proceed.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Counselor.
You are employed with the Orange County Sheriff's Office?
Correct.
And you are a crime scene investigator?
Correct.
Okay. And on July 17th of 2008, were you so employed?
Correct. Orange County Sheriff's Office.
And were you working at the forensics bay when a deputy, Jason Forgy, was called to inspect Ms. Anthony's vehicle?
Correct.
Okay. And did you prepare a report on this?
Yes, I did some report.
Do you have a copy of that with you today?
Yes, I do.
If you go to page 4,
refer to,
I'll direct you to, if you,
page 4, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. Just so you know, for your knowledge, I have your deposition transcript as well, if that'll also assist you in recalling.
Mr. Baez, did we get his full name?
I apologize, Judge. I'm trying to move things along.
I know.
Can you please state your name for the record, sir?
My name is Geraldo Bloise, G-E-R-A-R-D-O, Bloise, last name B-L-O-I-S-E.
Okay. Investigator Bloise, on the 17th, you were working at the forensics bay at the Orange County Sheriff's Office, correct?
Correct.
And do you recall when Deputy Forgy came out to deploy his cadaver dog?
Correct.
Now, during this time, you were asked to move the car outside of the garage?
Correct.
And at whose request was that?
That was requested by, if I remember, by the Deputy Jason Forgy.
Okay. And when you did that, do you recall how he conducted his search?
When I moved the vehicle from the bay, so get out of the car, and then he walked around the vehicle with his canine.
Let me stop you there. May I ask the witness to step down and
you may.
Come on over here and draw it out for us if you can.
Sure.
If you can draw a forensics bay garage and car.
Should be east side.
Okay.
The west side. Vehicle was at this area, the west side.
Okay.
This is the driveway. And I moved the vehicle outside the driveway.
Okay, can you draw a little car there?
Sure.
Where was the front of the car?
This way.
Okay. Now, where did Deputy Forgy begin his search?
My better recollection is start walk with the dog in this area here, around the car.
And where did he stop?
He stopped right here, at my desk approach in this area. Then after that, he instructed me to open the driver's side and the trunk. I did that simultaneously. So I opened the driver, I opened the trunk, and then he continued again. Dog smelled a little bit in the driver's side door, and then going this way again. And then he stopped, smelled, lift a little bit the head, smelled near to the trunk and sat in the area, in this area.
Okay.
The right rear fender.
Okay.
Did he ask you to open the car door?
Yes. Later.
Okay. And were there any other cars that he searched on that day other than that one?
That was the only vehicle in the parking area.
Okay. Were you present when he did the search for Tony Lazaro's car?
No.
Okay. You weren't working that day?
I don't remember that day.
Okay. All right. Did you see Deputy Forgy later on at the Anthony home?
Yes.
Okay. Why don't you put your name and date, that if you can, please, and then you can have a seat. Okay, so you arrive at the home and you see Deputy Forgy at the Anthony home?
Yes, that was the same day.
Okay. What happened when you arrived?
And that was when I arrived, before that, it was something that was disturbed. They found some disturbance on the sand and the ground. So and then later on, they decided to call K-9. Deputy Jason Forgy arrived. He did his inspection and with his canine, and that's it.
Okay. Were you informed, or did you see the dog alert at all?
No. He went by himself and his dog to the backyard. I never went there.
Okay. I hate to bring you back. I
sure.
I wanted to ask you one question about the car. Did he have the dog on the leash?
My best recollection, probably. Probably yes.
What about when he searched the backyard?
No, I never went to the backyard when he went to with his dog there. He walked by himself and with his dog.
So they asked everybody to leave the backyard?
And yeah.
Okay. So the only one who can testify as to what the dog did in the backyard is Deputy Forgy?
Correct.
Okay. And were you present when the second cadaver dog came out to the backyard?
Yes, I observed when K-9 from Osceola, deputy came with the K-9, and the same thing. She went to the backyard. I never went there, and she inspected the backyard.
That would be Deputy Brewer?
I don't have right now her name in my report. Probably, yes.
Okay. All you know is she was from Osceola County?
Exactly, yeah.
Okay. And was everybody asked to leave when Deputy Brewer came?
No, because, you know, the backyard was, nobody was in the backyard, so she was available to go immediately to the backyard. Nobody okay. was there.
Was Deputy Forgy allowed back there?
I don't remember he went back there. I don't remember that.
Okay. If I could have just a moment, Judge. What about the next day? Actually, let me stop you there. Were you ever informed that the cadaver dogs had alerted in the backyard?
Yes, they informed me some special areas that he has, the dog has some special interest, and then we mark it as 1, 3, 4, and 5 markers in the ground, in the playground area.
And these areas were then dug up?
Not the same day. You know, just we moved some areas. We checked briefly the ground and the playground. And then the next day, the other forensic squad arrived at the forensic, I mean at the Cindy Anthony's resident, and started to search the area.
Was the scene secured overnight?
Yes, okay. Was secure.
So somebody was there to make sure there was no
nobody.
Monkey business going on in the
Correct.
Meantime. Okay. Now, the next day, the CSI came out?
The group, the CSIs.
Okay.
The next day was my day off. Okay. I was not present at that day.
So you weren't present when?
No.
Okay. Did you witness any other deployments by any cadaver dogs in this case?
I think that's it.
Okay. All right. I have no further questions.
Cross-examination?
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Be excused.